Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome back to our channel once again. And it is my hope and prayer that this video is going to find you guys in good health. Personally, I am fine as you can see. Kisumu is fantastic. And maybe you could also let me know where you're watching the video from. The county or the country, in case you are out of the republic. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to ask you this question. I want to begin this video by asking you this question. Why do you think William Ruto fears Uhuru Kenyatta? Because clearly Uhuru Kenyatta is William Ruto's biggest political headache in the Republic of Kenya. Recently, when the Gen Z stormed parliament, William Ruto addressed the nation. And these were his words.
However, our national conversation on any subject matter must be conducted in a manner that respects and honors the foundational values upon which our nation is established, namely constitutionalism, the rule of law, and respect for institutions. It is very painful for Kenya that a conversation this crucial was hijacked by dangerous people who have caused us the kind of loss we have incurred as a nation today. It is possible that the criminals who rained terror on innocent people and attempted to challenge our law enforcement deployments are still determined to continue with their dangerous behavior. I assure the nation of the government's determination to fulfill its constitutional duty of protecting the people of Kenya against all forms of harm. I hereby put on notice the planners, financiers, orchestrators, and abettors of violence and anarchy that the security infrastructure established to protect our republic and its sovereignty will be deployed to secure the country and restore normalcy. Government will therefore uphold its constitutional mandate to secure our nation and its development and shall treat every threat to national security and the integrity of our state as an existential danger to our republic. Accordingly, I assure Kenyans that we shall provide a full, effective, and expeditious response to today's treasonous events.
And because I like calling a spade and not a big spoon, the person William Ruto was making reference to, in my view, is either Uhuru Kenyatta or Rigathi Gachagua. But I think he was referring to Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Recently, I think, was it the other day? The Cabinet Secretary for Defense, Eden Duale, also made this statement.
On that Tuesday, outside the agencies, there was a systematic plan to ban Parliament, to ban Supreme Court, and maybe the whole of the government square, and then go to State House. God has saved. Kenya Defense Forces, our security agents, did good work to make sure they saved those institutions.
So what you're saying is you made the right call?
The Constitution made the right call. I think the framers of our Constitution created checks and balances.
But you made that call that evening.
Oh, yes, as the chairman of the Defense Council, in consultation with the CDF and the Commander-in-Chief, we invoked the articles in the Constitution, the section in KDF Act, to make sure that our country does not slide into chaos because of greedy, wicked, politicians and their agents and their financiers. And they know themselves, and I'm sure they're watching me tonight.
They're watching?
I am sure they're watching me. Some in the previous administration, some even in our current administration.
Which begs the question, why do they fear Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta? Uhuru Kenyatta handed over power. Why do they fear him? And let me just take you back a bit and demonstrate to you guys that William Ruto has some fear of Uhuru Kenyatta. Number one, at some point, William Ruto tried to forcefully take control of Jubilee Party. I don't know how that ended. I think the last time I followed it, it must have been some court case. Huh? Number two, Uhuru Kenyatta's farm was raided. Uhuru Kenyatta is a former president. His farm raided. The current president just proceeded on with his life as if nothing ever happened. So far, nobody has ever been arrested as a result of that raid. Number three, there was the withdrawal of Uhuru Kenyatta's mother's security. As a former first lady, she's entitled to some security and I think some benefits constitutionally. And when the security were withdrawn, I thought, why would the government withdraw security of an old lady? Okay? But there was this incident where Uhuru Kenyatta's son was raided in his house or residence. Again, that was a clear act of targeting Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. But William Ruto clearly fear Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Why? Before I give you the details, in case you're watching this channel for the first time, please take a second or two, click that subscribe button so that next time you produce a video like this, YouTube will automatically notify you. And to the subscribers, I want to continue thanking you guys for your continued support. Because without that support, this channel cannot be where it is. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, allow me to dive in. But before I dive in, allow me to also take this opportunity to thank the following people. You are seeing their names there for the coffee which they sent to me earlier today. You can also do the same using the numbers you are seeing on your screen. Ladies and gentlemen, why do you think William Ruto and his government fear Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta? Why? Number one, I think it's because of Uhuru Kenyatta's silence. You see, since leaving office, Kenya Kwanza government have really tried to provoke Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. But Uhuru Kenyatta has maintained his silence. That is something that is worrying these guys. They don't know what Uhuru Kenyatta is actually thinking. At some point, I think Uhuru Kenyatta even went out of the country. Uhuru Kenyatta even used Ugandan airline because William Ruto refused to facilitate his international engagements. So I think because Uhuru Kenyatta is silent, these guys don't know what he is thinking. Of course, you all know that Uhuru Kenyatta made it very clear during after William Ruto swearing in, that his leader is Raila Amolo Odinga. And he has maintained that up to now. And because Uhuru Kenyatta is silent, these guys don't know what he's thinking. And of course, we all know that Uhuru Kenyatta and William Ruto did not separate politely. I mean, it was a bit bitter. The other reason why William Ruto fear Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta is because Uhuru Kenyatta is a very wealthy man. And that's a very big problem. With deep pockets, the fear is that Uhuru Kenyatta can fund the opposition. He can fund political activities. He can fund anti-government protest. And that's why when the protest took place, they had to drag the name of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Because the GNC organized something which they never anticipated. So because of the deep pocket. The reason why they also fear that, you know, with the deep pocket, it means that if Uhuru Kenyatta were to decide to rally around a candidate, that candidate will automatically have enough resources to challenge William Ruto. So that's the second reason why there is that fear. Number three, the failure by Uhuru Kenyatta to lend his support to William Ruto. You know, despite the fact that these two gentlemen fell out bitterly, even me, I'm surprised that they're not talking. Yeah. My expectation was that as a former president, Uhuru Kenyatta was going to support William Ruto in one way or the other. Up to now, I'm still figuring out why Uhuru can't do that. Is it because William Ruto is not embracing him? Or is it because their fallout was so bitter? Or what? Or is it because of the acts and omissions of William Ruto, like, for example, raiding their farm, the son incident, maybe the mother? Yeah, maybe Uhuru Kenyatta being frustrated, his allies being kicked out of government. So that failure, because if Uhuru Kenyatta had just declared his support for William Ruto, do you think William Ruto would be frustrating him? I don't think so. So because he has refused to support Ruto, Ruto and his allies are like, this guy must be up to something. Number four, Uhuru Kenyatta is a former president. Uhuru Kenyatta served for 10 good years. Before that, Uhuru Kenyatta was a deputy. Uhuru Kenyatta was a deputy prime minister when Raila Odinga was the minister. I mean, was the prime minister. Before that, Uhuru Kenyatta was Moi's or KANU presidential candidate, serving Moi. So it means even at that time, Uhuru Kenyatta was very influential, which means Uhuru Kenyatta has been able to plant his people within government. Uhuru Kenyatta has sympathizers in government. And that is something which is worrying William Ruto, which means there is nothing they can actually do without Uhuru Kenyatta knowing. I remember at some point, was it last year, when Uhuru Kenyatta used to get a lot of intelligence, and they would share through the media, through his team, because I know how some of these things operate. And William Ruto was really worried. William Ruto government cannot do anything today without Uhuru Kenyatta knowing. And because of that, William Ruto's fear can actually be summarized into two, as far as Uhuru Kenyatta's sympathizers are concerned. These guys might decide to sabotage William Ruto if they want. Because we know, as much as Ruto is the president, there are so many things which he's doing which are not right. So those who are sympathetic to Uhuru Kenyatta might say, okay, because we are seeing the people don't want this, let us continue implementing this so that this guy can be hated by the public. And of course, number two, some of these sympathizers will continue feeding Uhuru Kenyatta with information. Of course, William Ruto can also not just wake up and start firing everybody in government, because you don't know, even small people, a security officer there, this guy there, some of them are pro Uhuru Kenyatta. Number five, and this is William Ruto's biggest fear, the Mount Kenya factor in Ruto's political equation. Now, since William Ruto fell out with the Rigathi Gachagua, why do you think he's being linked to Uhuru Kenyatta? Ebu, listen to Rigathi Gachagua here.
Nakuja kulecture watu ya Mount Kenya ukiwa nani? Musidharau sisi kwa sababu tulipeana kura kwa kupenda. Musituchukue ufala. Musifikiria sisi ni watu ya kukanyangwa na mtu yeyote anataka kutokanyanga. Mimi nataka kuambia wewe, enda kwenu. Go and mobilize the 80% that did not vote for President William Ruto to vote for him in 2027. So hiyo namna hiyo. Mimi niligangana hapa siku mwelewana. Na makosa ya Uhuru ilikuwa moja peke yake. Kasi alikuwa amefanya, amejenga barabara, ameleta maji, amefanya kila kitu. Tukamchukia, tukampiga, tukamdharau kwa sababu ya kutetea Raila Odinga. Siku rais wetu ameona inafaa washikane na Raila Odinga, mimi nikajiuliza kama kiongozi, nitakuwa mjinga kiasi gani kama yule Raila tulikuwa tunapiga Uhuru juu yake wameshikana na rais wetu. Hata mimi nikasema Uhuru ni wetu, ni mtoto wetu, aheshimiwe na tukae pamoja.
Now, if you listened to Rigathi Gachagua clearly, there's a point he was telling William Ruto that we voted for you 84%. Then the remainder, if you bring Uhuru Kenyatta, would be 100%. So my interpretation of that is that Rigathi Gachagua is telling William Ruto that don't joke with Mount Kenya. And as a matter of fact, if you are to remove Mount Kenya factor from William Ruto's politics, I don't know whether we'll have William Ruto standing on his feet, politically speaking. And because Uhuru Kenyatta is a former president who served the people, and now they are saying Uhuru Kenyatta actually delivered. Well, William Ruto told them Uhuru did not deliver. These guys are now regretting. And that is making William Ruto fear Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Number six, the main reason why Wiper, NAP Kenya, ODM, Roots Party are still together under Azimio is because of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Uhuru Kenyatta is the uniting factor in these guys. You remove Uhuru Kenyatta, Azimio would be dead. And that's why William Ruto is living in fear that Uhuru Kenyatta is able to hold these guys together. Without Uhuru Kenyatta, Azimio would not be there. And lastly, the revenge mission. During William Ruto's swearing-in ceremony, Uhuru Kenyatta was really humiliated. Rigathi Gachagua was assigned that task, and he delivered it by really humiliating Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Uhuru Kenyatta is yet to accept the fact that William Ruto managed to win the presidency against all odds. And that's a very big problem. He's now planning for the revenge. And William Ruto is making matters worse by not trying to reach out to Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. So let us wait and see. But I don't know why, I don't understand why William Ruto should continue fearing Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Until next time, this is Lee Makwiny. Bye-bye.